Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and a very good day to the viewers of this video. First of all, my name is Nur Syahida binti Azmi, 17 years old, and I'm very proud to represent my school, Sekolah Menengah Kebangsaan Gaal, Pasir Putih, Kelantan. Today, I'm gonna be reviewing a storybook. The title of this book is Fairy Tales by Grimm Brothers. It was first published by penerbit Arowana Sindiran Berhad on 2003. This book contains 119 pages and 17 stories that has been retold by Susie Leong. Today, I'm gonna review one of them, and the title of the story is The Fisherman and His Wife. Once upon a time, there was a fisherman who lives together with his wife in a hut close by the sea. The fisherman used to go out all day long to fishing, and one day, as he went fishing and sat on the shore with his rod, all on a sudden, his float was dragged away deep into the water, and when he drew it up again, surprisingly, he brought out a large flounder. You must be questioning something. What is flounder? Flounders are a group of flatfish species. They are demersal fish that can be found at the bottom of oceans around the world. What was most surprising, the flounder could talk. It told the fisherman that it was not a real fish and it would not taste good. It begged to the fisherman to be put back into the water, so with nothing twice, the man put it back into the water. When the man reached home, he told his wife about everything that had happened. His wife was so furious with him for letting go of the flounder without making any demands, so she asked him to go back to the sea and get the fish back to grant them the wishes. He went again, stood by the sea, and called out the flounder. The flounder appeared and asked him what he wanted. He said that his wife wanted a big house, and as he returned home, his wife was standing outside the new house. It was beautifully furnished. There were hens and ducks in the yard, also garden of flowers and fruit trees. A week later, his wife said that it was too small. She wanted a castle. The man was not too agreed, but his wife bothered him so much about it, so he went again and called out the flounder. He said nervously to the flounder that his wife wanted a castle. As he returned home, he saw his wife was waiting for him in front of a stone castle. The hall was paved with marble and many servants greeted them. The table was full of food and wine waiting for them. The next day, when they woke up in the morning, his wife looked out the window and saw a beautiful countryside. She told her husband that she wanted them to be a king and queen of all the land. She gave him no peace till he went back to the sea to look the flounder. But this time, the water became dark grey and the waves were high. When the flounder responded to his call, he said that his wife wanted to be a queen. And as he returned home, he saw a bigger castle with magnificent towers and many soldiers on guard. He saw his wife on a throne with a golden crown on her head and a jeweled scepter in her hand. On both sides, there were many maids in waiting. And when night came, as they went to bed, she couldn't sleep. She turned about restlessly while her husband slept soundly. In the next morning, she watched the sun rising and woke her husband. She told him that she wished to be made as powerful as God and she wanted to order the sun and the moon to rise whenever she wished. Her husband fell on his knees and reminded her to just stay a queen. Her wishes were too much. She was so furious that she hit and kicked him. The man felt pain as he stood by the sea. He cried out to the flounder and said that his wife wanted to be a god. The flounder was too angry. It asked him to go back and he would find his wife in the old hut. And they are probably living there to this day. Dear viewers, there are pretty obvious moral of this story. Remember, if you can't find the happiness in things you already have, then you will never be happy no matter which of your wishes will come true. Like in the story, even though the fisherman seemingly had a good heart, but it was not enough to make him happy because his wife was so greedy. So the lesson that we can learn is, be grateful for what you have or the greediness will get you nothing. That's all from me. Thank you and have a nice day. Bye!